Green Beret killed in Niger, still kept fighting after being shot 18 times. A recent military investigation into a Nigerian ambush reveals some stunning insight into the late Army Sergeant Law David T. Johnson. After being shot 18 times, this Green Beret kept fighting back as he and two other Nigerian soldiers tried to escape. The U.S.-Niger patrol had been looking for a senior Islamic State member who had ties to Al-Qaeda. After going to a location where he was last seen, the patrol had stopped in a village to get some food and water. According to We Are the Mighty, the U.S. military believes someone in the village may have tipped off attackers to the presence of U.S. commandos and Nigerian forces in the area, setting in motion the ambush. The ambush took place on October 4, about 120 miles from the Nigerian capital of Niamey. It was then that Johnson and three other Americans were killed, Staff Sergeant Brian C. Black, 35, of Puyallup, Washington, Staff Sergeant Jeremiah W. Johnson, 39, of Springboro, Ohio, and Staff Sergeant Dustin M. Wright, 29, of Lyons, Georgia. In total, four U.S. soldiers and four Nigerian troops were killed while two U.S. troops and eight Nigerian troops were wounded. There had been some scrutiny in the timeline of the events. Now, the investigative report by the military sheds some new light on the situation. When the military went to locate the bodies from the attack, they found three of the Green Berets, but not Johnson. Because of this, We Are the Mighty says there were rumors of Johnson's whereabouts after the ambush. Some said that he was killed at close range while others that he was captured alive. Instead, the report concluded that Johnson was struck as many as 18 times from a distance by a volley of machine gun rounds, according to the U.S. officials, who said he was firing back as he and two Nigerian soldiers tried to escape. Additionally, the officials said Johnson was found under thick scrub brush where he tried to take cover. There were no indications he was shot at close range, or had been bound or taken prisoner, as several media reports have suggested. We will receive the final report on this investigation next month. These guys weren't expecting to be attacked the way they were in October, but their deaths reveal the unwavering truth behind our military. Our guys keep fighting even when the odds look slim. These soldiers are heroes and should be commemorated as such. When asked to do so, they gave the ultimate sacrifice to help keep America safe. Thank you for your service, and thank you for your sacrifice. You will always be remembered.